Hello, everyone, and welcome to the April 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hi, everyone.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month. First up this month, on April 1st, the moon and the open cluster, the Pleiades, will be about 3.5 degrees apart. The moon will be a crescent, about 18% full. It's shown close up here at about 8 p.m.
The Lyrid meteor shower will peak from the evening of April 21st to the morning of April 22nd. Named after the Lyra constellation, the Harp, the meteors appear to radiate from this region of the sky near the bright star Vega. At its peak, the shower is expected to produce about 20 meteors per hour, with occasional fireballs. During this time, the moon will be 35% illuminated as a waning crescent and won't interfere with viewing until after 3:13 a.m.
The planets Venus and Saturn make a comeback into our sky, but this time in the early morning. Wake up early to see them, along with Mercury, rising in the east. Here they are at 5:30 a.m. on April 25th. On April 30th, the crescent moon will join the planet Jupiter and the bright stars Capella, Betelgeuse, Rigel, and Aldebaran just above the western horizon. This gathering will be an impressive sight that you do not need a telescope to see. Catch it before the moon sets, which will be around 11:30 p.m. Let's take a look at what constellations we'll see this month. To the south, we no longer see the very bright, recognizable stars of the wintertime. We will now see the constellation Leo, the Lion, and its bright star Regulus, high in the sky, along with the very dim stars of Hydra, the water snake. Here in Los Angeles, many of those stars of Hydra are nearly washed out by light pollution, so this sky may not seem as dramatic as the winter sky.
Looking east, the bright orange star Arcturus, located in the constellation Boötes the Herdsman, dominates the sky. To the southeast, Spica, the brightest star in Virgo the Maiden, radiates in a bluish hue. Just below Boötes, Corona Borealis, the northern crown, forms a semi-circular arrangement of stars, most visible under a clear dark sky. To the west, by 10 p.m. in mid-month, the winter constellations Orion, Taurus, and Canis Major are near the horizon. Above them, Gemini and Auriga, setting just before 2 a.m.
Now, let's take a look at the planets, starting with the planet Jupiter. All month, Jupiter will appear to move slowly towards the tip of the horns of Taurus, while Taurus is moving closer to the horizon. This will be the last month to view Jupiter high in the sky. Saturn will be too close to the sun to view for most of the month, but as we mentioned earlier, it will start to be visible again in the early morning. Here we see it on April 1st at 6:10 a.m. on the horizon, just before the sun rises. It is only about 6 degrees above the horizon, so it's not a great object to look at just yet. While you're out looking for Saturn early in the morning, you will not miss the very bright planet Venus above it on the horizon. The planet Mercury reaches its greatest elongation in our morning sky on April 21st. From April 1st to April 21st, the planet will very subtly climb higher in the sky earlier in the morning. But on the 22nd, it will begin its inward motion toward the other side of the sun. This is not the best appearance of Mercury, so it is a real challenge to see it, and it is pretty unlikely to be spotted.
At the start of the month, Mars is near the 3.5 magnitude star Kappa Geminorum. The pair is best viewed with binoculars. Having been in Gemini since January, watch Mars throughout this month as it begins to move swiftly eastward. By the 10th, watch as Mars moves 3 degrees or 6 moon diameters eastward away from Gemini. By the 20th, Mars has moved into Cancer the Crab. On the 30th, Mars moves into the heart of Cancer the Crab, marked by 4 faint stars. It is positioned just above the dim star Eta Cancri. Throughout the month, Mars moves eastward by 12 degrees, which is the same distance the moon travels in one day.
And that's it for the planets. Here is your lunar calendar for the month of April. First quarter is on the 4th. Full moon is on the 12th. Last quarter is on the 20th. And the new moon is on the 27th. Thank you so much for joining us for the month of April, and we'll see you again next month. Bye!
Bye.
This, for real. Hello, everyone. Oh, sorry.